Welcome to Bio-Rad's workshop, CRISPR Confirmation, Genotyping CRISPR-Cas9 Gene Editing with the Out of the Blue Genotyping Extension. My name is Lee Brown, and I'm a curriculum and training specialist for the Explorer Education Team at Bio-Rad Laboratories. If you have any questions about this presentation or any of our other labs, please feel free to email explorer@biorad.com. Be sure to check out the links in the description below to get more information about this lab and other resources. We have a couple of other videos in the series that you may want to watch. CRISPR Explained covers applications of CRISPR technology and how CRISPR-Cas9 works, including a demo of our free paper model. The second video, CRISPR Gene Editing, covers the Bio-Rad Out of the Blue CRISPR kit, including a video walkthrough of the student lab. In this video, we'll start off with an overview of the Out of the Blue CRISPR gene editing activity, and then talk about how we can use PCR to determine the genotype. Next, you'll see an activity walkthrough where we actually go through the student protocol of the genotyping activity and cover the expected results. Let's start with an overview of the Out of the Blue gene editing lab first. Your students should have already completed this lab before doing the genotyping extension. In the gene editing lab, students use CRISPR technology to edit the LacZ gene of E. coli. Bacteria with a functional LacZ gene express an enzyme that breaks down XGAL and produces a blue pigment. On this plate, which contains XGAL, we see bacteria that are expressing LacZ, and the colonies are blue. Bacteria without a functioning LacZ gene do not make the enzyme, so they are not able to break down XGAL. These bacteria are white, even when grown on plates containing XGAL. So, how can we go from blue colonies to white colonies, like the one shown here? In the gene editing lab, students used CRISPR to cut the LacZ gene and add an insert. The LacZ gene in edited bacteria will no longer function, and those bacteria form white colonies. In the gene editing lab, students start with blue bacteria with the functional LacZ gene, then perform a transformation and plate the transformed bacteria. You can learn more about this lab in our CRISPR gene editing video. After several days, students will see different phenotypes depending on the starter bacteria and plasmid they use to transform. Their plates may have no colonies, white colonies, or blue colonies. Which phenotype would you expect to see if students successfully use CRISPR to edit their bacteria? How can students confirm that they use CRISPR to edit their bacteria? In the genotyping extension, students can look at the genotype of their transformed bacteria to confirm their results. Why is it so important that scientists check their work? Let's take a look at a real-world example. Normally, the horns of dairy calves are removed. Scientists at a startup company called Recombinetics use gene editing to swap out just a few nucleotides so the dairy calves never grew those pesky horns. But when the FDA took a closer look at the genome of the cows, they discovered some remnants of the cloning vector, including bacterial genes for antibiotic resistance. The company had claimed that the animals were 100% bovine, but they had neglected to verify their work by genotyping. Because the gene-edited calves have traces of bacterial DNA, they were now considered genetically modified organisms, or GMOs, and thus subject to FDA regulation. This story really drives home the importance of genotype verification to ensure your target DNA was edited in the way you intended and that there weren't any off-site targets. In the genotyping extension, students extract the DNA from their bacterial colonies and use PCR to visualize the genotypes and determine if the DNA was modified as they expected. The genotyping extension lab has three different primer sets. The first set is designed to detect unmodified LacZ. One primer in this set binds directly to the target site. If the site was modified, the primer won't bind. If the target site was not modified, then this primer set will yield an 1100 base pair amplicon. The second primer set is designed to detect edited LacZ. One primer in this set binds to the insert. And if the bacteria were successfully gene edited, PCR will yield a 650 base pair amplicon. A third set of primers will amplify an unrelated region of the bacterial chromosome, far outside of the LacZ gene, as a control. This allows students to verify that they successfully extracted and amplified bacterial chromosomal DNA. This primer set will yield a 350 base pair amplicon, whether or not LacZ was modified. Instructor prep for this lab is fairly straightforward. They'll aliquot the instant gene, controls, marker, loading die, master mix, and primers. And you'll also need to prepare gels and electrophoresis buffer.
Let's take a look at what you'll need for the first day of the lab. You'll need your bacterial plates from the gene editing lab, a starter plate, plate C with blue colonies, and plate D with white colonies. You'll need a rack with tubes containing Instagene, master mix plus primers, your positive and negative controls, and 5 empty screw cap tubes. You'll need a PCR tube rack with 7 empty PCR tubes, a permanent marker, a cup for trash, 3 micropipettes, P20, P200, P1000, and tips. You'll also need 2 dry baths or water baths set to 56 and 95 degrees Celsius. You'll need a centrifuge. And finally, you'll need a thermocycler. Today, we're using the Bio-Rad T100. Label 5 screw cap tubes S for starter plate, C, D1, D2, and D3. Flick the Instagene matrix to mix it up and add 250 microliters to each tube. Use a yellow tip to pick a single blue colony from the X era starter plate. Swirl the tip in tube S until you don't see any bacteria on the tip. Use a new tip to pick a single blue colony from the C plate. Swirl the tip in tube C until no more bacteria remain on the tip. Use a new tip to pick a single white colony from plate D. Swirl the tip in tube D1 until you don't see any more bacteria on the tip. And repeat this twice more for tubes D2 and D3, using a new tip each time. Make sure the tubes are closed completely and flicks or vortex to mix. Incubate the tubes in a dry bath or water bath for 15 minutes at 56 degrees Celsius. Let the tubes cool slightly, then flix or vortex the tubes to mix. Put the tubes in a dry bath or water bath set to 95 degrees Celsius for 8 minutes. Let them cool slightly, then flix or vortex the tubes to mix. At this point, you can stop and store your samples in the fridge or continue on. centrifugal tubes at 6,000 G for 5 minutes or 12,000 G for 2 minutes. Label 7 PCR tubes S, C, D1, D2, D3, plus and minus. Add 10 microliters of Master Mix Plus Primers, MMP, to each tube. Using a new tip each time, add 10 microliters of supernatant from each of the 5 screw cap tubes into its matching PCR tube. Be careful that you don't transfer any of the instagene matrix beads. Those will inhibit PCR. Using a new pipette tip, add 10 microliters of positive PCR control DNA to the positive PCR tube, and add 10 microliters of negative PCR control DNA into the negative PCR tube. Place the tubes in the thermal cycler and run the cycle indicated in the manual. After the program is finished, the samples can be left in the thermal cycler overnight or stored in the fridge. For the electrophoresis lab, you'll need tips and a P20 micropipette, a centrifuge, TAE buffer, we're using 0.25x, a horizontal gel electrophoresis chamber and power supply, molecular weight ruler and loading die, your 7 PCR samples, a 1% agarose gel. If you're using UView, you'll also need a UView transilluminator to view your gels. If you aren't using UView, you'll need a staining tray and fast blast. Pull spin your PCR tubes to make sure the contents are at the bottom. Add 5 microliters of loading dye to each sample using a new tip each time. Pipette up and down to mix. Here we're using UView, which is a fluorescent loading dye and DNA stain, so we'll be able to use a UV transilluminator to view our DNA immediately after gel electrophoresis. Put a 1% TAE agarose gel into the gel chamber. We're using a precast gel here, which has 2 rows of 8 wells each, so this gel will accommodate 2 student groups. Make sure that the gel is oriented so that the wells at the top are closest to the black electrode. Fill the electrophoresis chamber with enough TAE buffer to completely cover the gel. Using a new tip for each sample, load 20 microliters of the molecular weight ruler, MWR. Load 15 microliters of the positive control, PCR samples S, C, D1, D2, and D3, and the negative control. Put the lid on the chamber. Connect the leads to the power supply and run the gel. The lab is available to purchase with or without DNA electrophoresis reagents, and we have two options for staining. Our UVU 6X loading dye and stain enables students to see their results immediately after electrophoresis with a UV transilluminator or a handheld UV light. You can also purchase the lab with FastBlast, which is a visible stain. DNA bands will appear after incubating for several minutes to overnight if you're using FastBlast. Let's take a quick look at the expected results. Our marker is in lane 1, and the positive PCR control is in lane 2. You'll see 3 DNA bands for each of the 3 PCR targets. A 1050 base pair unmodified like Z target, a 650 base pair edited like Z target, and a 350 base pair control target. Using the positive control bands, spend a minute with a slide and make some predictions about which bands you'd expect to see for these two plates. The plate on the left has blue colonies. Would you expect those bacteria to have unmodified or modified like Z? What about the plate on the right with white colonies? Would you expect unmodified or edited like Z? Which of these plates should have the control target DNA band? You can visit our website at biorad.com/out-of-the-blue to find ordering information for the Out of the Blue Genotyping Extension and the refill pack. The Genotyping Extension kit comes with the reagents and all the plastic consumables you'll need to do the lab, and the refill pack contains only the reagents. We hope you enjoyed this presentation. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click the links below for more information about this lab and our other Bio-Rad kits.
Subscribe to the Bio-Rad Explorer channel and you'll discover enriching and fun biology and life science videos. Watch what you'll explore. Subscribe now.